بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Sulaiman was given a kingdom that no one in the past and no one in the future will ever have. And his kingdom, as I mentioned, my brothers and sisters, wasn't only the buildings and the countries and the state and the land. It wasn't only wealth, but the kingdom of Sulaiman, it's a miracle within itself. And Allah Azza wa Jalla gave Sulaiman the armies of the jinn. They work under his commands. Whatever Sulaiman orders the jinn, they must do.
There was a very interesting rumor that spread at the time that the jinn, they know the unseen. And Allah wanted to prove, forget about the unseen. They don't even know what is in front of them at times. How did Allah prove that? Sulaiman alayhi salam used to stand with his stick. They were frightened.
And they used to get scared from Sulaiman. When Sulaiman used to order them to do something, they run to it. And when Sulaiman is present, they'll continue to work. And they used to build palaces for Sulaiman alayhi salam. And one day, when they were building a big, massive palace for Sulaiman, Sulaiman was there present, watching them. And when the jinn see Sulaiman is there, they'll be so active non-stop. And there Sulaiman is watching, monitoring what the jinn are doing and building. And he had a stick. While he was on that stick, at that time Allah Azza wa Jalla took his soul. It's been narrated that Sulaiman alayhi salam passed away leaning on that stick with his eyes opened. Who's continuing to work? The jinn. And the jinn are working so hard. Sulaiman, when is he going to go? When is he going to give us a break? He's still watching us.
A day passed, 2 days passed, a time passed, a long time passed, and all the jinn were working very, very hard in front of him, building something that he had wanted. When he passed away, Sulaiman, in that position with his stick, nothing led them to know that he died except the little ant that started eating the stick. The stick was wooden. The ant started eating the stick. When the ant began to eat the stick from the bottom, as it came up, at a certain point, after some time, the stick broke. When the stick broke, Sulaiman alayhi salam, who was balanced on it as a dead man, dropped. So Allah says, when he fell down, it was now known to everybody that had the jinn known the unseen, they would not have been punishing themselves by working so tirelessly.
Subhanallah, the jinn, they do not know al-ghaib. The magicians and the fortune tellers, they depend on al-jinn. And they claim that jinn know the future. And since we have connection with the jinn, we can know and tell what will happen in the future. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if the jinn knew al-ghaib, if they knew the unseen, they wouldn't have remained in the punishment. The jinn, they do not have any knowledge whatsoever about the unseen, except what they steal from the conversation when they eavesdrop on the angels. That's the only information that they have. And they mix one piece of truth with 99 lies.
That when he died, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it a great sign for humanity at large and for the jinn kind as well. That look, oh jinn, never mind, you don't know the unseen, but worse than that, something right in front of you, the man is dead, you don't even know he's dead.
In the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and until now, a lot of things have been attributed to Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi wa sallam, which are untrue. One of which is magic. There are some of al-Yahud, the Jews, who attribute magic to Sayyidina Sulaiman. For example, they associate Sulaiman alayhi salam with someone called Asmodeus. And this Asmodeus was the chief of the devils. And they associate him with Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam. And they say that this devil, the chief of the devils, was the one who assisted Sulaiman in building and constructing. And he is the one who used to teach Sulaiman magic. And you would find that many cults and movements, they attach themselves to Sulaiman alayhi salam. Many of these secret orders, they claim that they go back to Sulaiman alayhi salam. As the most famous of them is the Masonic movement, Al-Masoniya, the Freemasons. You would find that the concept of the Temple of Solomon, is something that is central, or it is very influential on the ideology of the Freemasons. Also, movements like Kabbalah and some of these other mystical Jewish cults, they practice magic which they claim they have learned from Suleiman. They claim that the lineage goes back to Suleiman. Now there is some truth that there is magic that goes back in lineage to some very early Jews. But it does not go back to Sayyidina Suleiman alayhi salam. It all goes back to where did the Jews learn this magic, that some of which still exist until now. And it's very powerful magic. We are not talking about tricks where you hide a coin and you bring it out from somewhere, or you bring something out of a hat. We are not talking about those tricks which they fool the kids with. We are talking about some serious magic that could do some serious harm. Where was that learned? In Babel.
And how ancient is Babylon? It is said to be the most ancient city. There was no city before the city of Babylon to that level. The first real civilization was Babylon. So we are going back pre-Ibrahim. We're going back to the earliest of times, way before Musa, way before Suleiman. So Allah is telling us, when did magic begin? This is the story. وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ بِبَابِلَ هَارُوتَ وَمَارُوتَ. And these Yahud are following what was revealed to the two angels of Babylon. These were called Harut and Marut. What was revealed to these two angels in Babel? Firstly, where is Babel? Where is Babylon? Iraq. Allah sent down two angels with the knowledge of how to control or access the jinn, which is magic. And the angels were sent to the city of Babylon. And the angels were allowed to teach anybody who wanted to study with them the quote-unquote art of magic. But the angels also claim with a big disclaimer. And that disclaimer was, the angels said to anybody who came to them, we are a test from Allah. So do not commit kufr by studying with us. Yet, if somebody insisted, they taught him. So the angels are a test. And they say they're a test. And they only teach somebody after they tell them, if you study this, you will become a kafir. But they were still there. So Allah says, the people studied from the two of them that which would cause a husband and wife to fall apart, to have problems and whatnot. And they could never harm anybody unless Allah willed it. Magic is not more powerful than Allah. If Allah wants to, He can prevent it. They studied that which only harms them and there is no benefit. So magic has zero benefit. It's only evil. And the angels taught or told the men, لَمَنْ اشْتَرَاهُ, whoever got this knowledge from them, they would have no share of the next world. And what an evil price they sold themselves for, لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ, if they only understood. And the angels claim with a disclaimer, if you study this, you're not a Muslim. And Allah has sent us to test you. But obviously the people of Babylon insisted and they studied it. So those who studied it became the first magicians of this humanity. And all magic that is existent today somehow goes back to Babylon.
So if you read about this history, you find that Babylon is associated to it all. There is a lot of association with Babylon. The secret orders, they came from Babylon rather than from Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and when there came to them a messenger from Allah, came to who? This is talking about Al-Yahud, the Jews. So they threw away the book of Allah when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came, because they don't want to follow him.
When the book came with the Prophet, they knew, they threw away this book behind their backs. And they rejected the Prophet even though they knew that this is the Prophet. So they did not follow the book. What did they follow? وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينَ. Instead of following the book of Allah, they followed that which the shayateen recited during the time of Sulaiman. What is this recitation of shayateen? What were the shayateen reciting?
The devils were teaching the people magic before the time of Sulaiman and during the kingdom of Sulaiman. Sulaiman came to know that the devils are teaching people magic. So he gathered all of their manuals and books. He took them away from the people, because the people used to record what they were learned from the devils. Sulaiman alayhi salam took away all of those manuals and books. And he made a law that whoever learns magic or practices magic or teaches magic will be executed. And he took away all of these books and manuals and he buried under his throne. He buried them and he made a law in his time that nobody should learn or teach or practice magic. This is from Shayateen.
He was so powerful, we had made mention that he had the power to subject all the jinn kind of the time, and he did it. And he used them in many different ways, some of them to build and to do so many other things. And Sulaiman alayhi salam, when he stood with his stick, they were frightened, they were scared of him. What did he do? He gathered all the books of magic. And where was the safest place to put all these books? Under his throne. So he placed them under his throne, he would be seated, nobody touched these books, and the magic stopped. Magic stopped. Now when that happened, there was a problem, because they saw Sulaiman alayhi salam instruct the wind, it would move so fast, a month's journey covered in a morning, another month's journey covered in the afternoon, by the instruction of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. He got the palace of Bilqis within a split second to be shifted from Sheba all the way to where he was, intact. And he renovated it within split seconds. And he built another palace next to it within split seconds. Amazing.
When Sulaiman alayhi salam passed away, Shaitan, Iblis, came to the people in the form of a human being. And he said, do you know where Sulaiman used to get his power from? The devils are the ones who used to teach him. And I will show you the proof. Go and dig under his throne and see what you will find. They went to dig under the throne. They saw the manuals and the books of magic. So they made a rumor and they said that this is how Sulaiman used to control the jinn, and this is how he achieved all of that power. It is through magic. And that's how they propagated this false rumor against Sayyidina Sulaiman. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to this claim and says, Wama kafara Sulaiman. Sulaiman has not committed kufr.
Sulaiman did not disbelieve. But the devils disbelieved, the shayateen disbelieved. They were the ones who were teaching people magic.
This shows us that practicing magic and believing in it makes you a kafir. Because the jinns accused Sulaiman of being a magician, not of being a kafir. And Allah defended Sulaiman by saying, He didn't say Sulaiman was not a magician. Rather, Allah said Sulaiman did not commit kufr.
Anyone who engages in magic or who seeks magical, meaning something magical from someone, they have lost their belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and entered into the fold of kufr. They've entered into the fold of disbelief.
Who are the ones who are teaching magic? The devils. وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ بِبَابِلِ. And what was revealed to the two angels in Babel? In Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rarely mentions places, unless there is a reason for mentioning a locality or a place. In Babel, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the place over here, in the ayah. The reason is because all of this magic or secret orders or distorted teachings came out of Babel. And we know that through history. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to record that in Quran so that we would learn where the source of all of these came from. It came from Babel. Because without reading Quran, by just reading the history and books that deal with this, you would be able to see this association with Babel. So when you read this in Quran, it's an amazing thing to see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tied this into Babel. And that then gives us the complete picture of what happened. This knowledge was learned by a faction of Al-Yahud, the Jews, and it has been inherited from generation to generation through secret orders, and part of that magic still exists until now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us one effect of such branch or type of magic. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they learned from these angels what could cause separation between man and his wife. It's a magic spell that is cast on the husband or the wife. And it would cause hatred in the heart of the husband or the wife. And it would make it unbearable. And eventually, it would cause divorce, separation. It is true that this exists. But also it is true that many people take it out of context. And whenever there is a problem between husband and wife, they hang it on magic. They said there is magic between them. And that's not true. Sometimes it's magic. Sometimes it's incompatibility of two persons. But this type of magic is not only limited to putting these differences between husband and wife. It could cause some other harm. And the way it's done, they have to have a part of your body, such as hair, nail, with the assistance of the jinn, would wrap it in what is called ugda. And they would wrap it with that part of your body in it. And they would throw it somewhere. And that is what would cause this problem or magic to take effect. The magician would think that by learning this knowledge, they could benefit. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, magic is purely harm and there is no benefit in it whatsoever. The magicians go through, when they follow this path, you would be amazed. Don't think that the devils teach them this knowledge for free. They pay for it. And they pay for it in the worst ways. The rituals the magicians go through before they are incepted, in the ranks of the magicians, it is thing that would make the hair on your body stand. They would make them drink the blood of menstrual. They would make them eat frogs and snakes and insects. They would make them write ayat of Quran with blood and step over it. They would make them make istinja with pages of Quran. They would make them make sujood to the devils. They would make them make sujood to idols. These are the rituals that the magicians have to go through before they get the assistance of the jinn. They do not offer their services for free. Jinn do not offer their services for free. The right way to heal is by reading Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in Quran is healing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, and indeed they knew that the buyers of it magic would have no share in the hereafter, and how bad indeed was that for which they sold their own selves. Because the magician sells himself, if they but knew, and if they had believed and guarded themselves from evil and kept their duty to Allah, far better would have been the reward from their Lord, if they but knew. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has fulfilled his dua when he said, O Allah, give me a kingdom that will occur to nobody else after me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him a unique kingdom.
He had also the authority to tie up these jinn in such a way that they would be slave for him, doing whatever he wants, all tied up in a line in a uniform fashion. He was able to jail them, to imprison them, to punish them, to use them in whatever way he wished.
Any one of these jinn who would go against the orders of Sulaiman will be punished. So as soon as Sulaiman alayhi salam passed away, they went to their normal jobs of the pre-Sulaimanic era, and that is to deviate people. This is the story of Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam.
We want to talk about a man that Allah Azza wa Jal, not only that he mentioned the Quran Kareem, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named a full surah after his name, and that's Surah Luqman. And the man that we want to talk about is Luqman al-Hakim.
Inshallah, we have an appointment with that. Until we meet again, wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad, subhanallah bihamdih, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.